Hello everyone and welcome back to some more Crusader Kings 2 Game of Thrones as House Harlaw of Ten Towers, and we're trying to remove the Drowned God religion. But first we'll have to convert to the Faith of the Seven ourselves. It's not that easy actually. I'm guessing the best way is I kill myself or just die, then Roderick has to die, then Eric has, well, yeah, probably, or then we can play as Eric. And his kids can potentially be fostered with someone else. Not sure if that's actually going to be possible, but that is certainly the plan. But yeah, let's actually, before we do anything else, let's find someone to marry. Now, this girl would be cool to get an alliance with Greywick, but she's already pregnant, so I don't really want her. Ursula, she's ruthless, rude, and shy, but she does have a lot of intrigue. That's certainly useful. What else have we got? Farwind, not really the best alliance. Orkwood. Is that Orkwind? Yeah. We're currently fabricating claim on these guys, so that's also not really too useful. Probably the Good Brothers are the best. She's ambitious, kind. I did look at this earlier, but I couldn't decide, which is why I'm gonna have to do this right now. Let's actually go fast forward while we're doing this. And yeah, by the way, I decided that I should go reaving simply because there's nothing else I can do. So yeah, let's do that. And you want me to go in the reave in the Summer Islands, so that's where we should do it. Hopefully that works out. Alright, other than that, currently can't do anything else. Train children. Well, are you trained? Okay, I was looking at marriages. There we go. And I think... Now, she's now pregnant, right? What happened to... She was... I know she was pregnant for a fact. But she is no longer pregnant. Interesting. Maybe we'll... Still, she seems odd. We're gonna go with Ursula. Yep. Marry that girl. And the men are ready, the longship's prepared. Now we begin our journey across the narrow sea to pay the iron price. Of course we will. And Roderick is now the regent. Unfortunately, he's still widowed, so we can't marry him off to anyone. And he's the only one who's not actually coming with us. Accepted this. Very nice. I'm actually married now. And I want cash. Please give me cash. And we have a new ambition where we probably want Valyrian steel sword would be nice. Mass wealth. 500 gold, that's not gonna happen. Master Arms, Castellan. I would like to be Master Arms, although it's unlikely. Have 5 children. Gain an army title. Yeah, let's try that. And educate our dear daughter. Okay, educate the child. And we should probably... We only have Roderick. Actually, no, we don't. We could make her a steward or fighter. We only have a dutiful commander. We have a good steward. I think we're gonna make Roderick. Yeah. Roderick. Educate our wife. And he's sending 50 gold over. That's nice. Don't really want to host a wedding feast. So expensive all the time. And we can't marry Roderick, unfortunately. We have a claim on the Iron Islands that we could press, but that would be highly stupid. Although, okay, he just has high taxes. Claim the Iron Islands for Gormant Walmark. Why would I do that? Pose liege. Theon Greyjoy would become new Lord Paramount. Ironborn longships cut through the water swift. The merchant fleet. Yes, we attacked the merchant fleet. Of course. And they were fairly defended. We lost a few men seizing their ships as well as taking some damage to our longships. But in the end, no one can resist the Ironborn Reavers. And much cargo as well as many captives were made. Nice. So this guy is still alive. Quentin, my spymaster, is still alive. Horace, my nephew. All good. This guy as well. It's all of my kinsmen. The hunchback as well. Everyone seems to be well. Okay, so we gain a little bit of prestige and 20 gold. Everyone likes me a little bit more. That was a success so far. A scout has spied a coastal fishing village. Let's do that as well. But these men who sow were more hardy than we thought. Our Ironborn managed to make a beachhead, but were fought back. We have failed to claim our iron prize today. Bugger. But we did get 20 gold so far. John Arryn wanted to imprison Lionel Corbray. Now he's taken up arms. And once more, a merchant fleet? Come on. Yes. More luck. We got 40 gold out of this. That's really nice. Okay, what is this guy? Employee of Master Yogan. Why would I want you? You're Craven. But you're my... Oh, he died. My uncle. I don't really want you, to be honest. That would be 20 gold. Sorry, bro, but nah. Although you're a mastermind scholar, probably should have taken you. I don't know. But 20 gold was too much a price to pay for someone I can probably just get onto my court anyways. And we need to plot. We need to plot something. Rescue him from King Rob's stock. Wait. King? Oh no, Robert Baratheon. Yeah, we could try that. I mean, why not? He's our ally, my father-in-law. Which is funny because he's younger than me. He's 40. I'm 58. I'm 18 years older, but he's my father-in-law. Well, that happens if you marry young. Come on, Rubik. The Reaving Party had been rowing the coast. Roving? Sorry. When a local patrol headed by a demi of Isle of Quivers attacked, we are of course easily butchered these people, but the glory surely belongs to Horus Harla, who bested Artemy in single combat to win the battle in our favor. He now expects to be rewarded. But this guy is still alive. Wow, he wants 20 gold. You know what? Fine. You know, you're a pretty cool dude. Dual skill of 10. Alright, fine. There you go, 20 gold. Wow. Gee. A son was born to Hothodi the Hunchback. Rolf. Alright. Humpback. Why is it a humpback? Isn't it called a hunchback? Oh, there you go. Yeah, I'm kind of confused, but alright. And another coastal village. Come on. We can do it. The rating was a resounding failure. Oh, many of our reavers were slain. Balon, actually, is unhappy about this. During the attack, Jorison Harla was wounded by an enemy fighter, but like a true Ironborn, he was chosen to stay with our band of reavers. Good man, of course. Don't die. I think he's the firstborn, isn't he? No, he's not. He's the second. Alright, come on. Another small merchant fleet. And yeah, another 20 gold. So successful. And this guy is also, he's even maimed now. Ooh. And Eric is also wounded. But, oh, he has chosen to go back home as a consequence. What a craven. And he is to rule after my son, Roderick. He's an honorable man. He's a trained fighter too. But he's more of a steward than anything else. We can imprison him. What is he doing? I don't understand. Okay, I can't. Another fishing village. Come on. Yes. Successful raid. Wow. We're getting so much money out of this. Siegfried Stonetree is wounded. Okay. But he's staying with us. Horus Harlaw has come to be a great companion. We have raided and pillaged together. We have slain many a man in battle side by side and feasted together in the celebration of Reaving. Well done in the true spirit of the Drowned God. Alright, well, I remember this time. Once I have converted to a favor of the Seven. What are these guys doing? Good brothers are raising their men against Tristan of Sealskin Point. Interesting. He's calling me into his war. Who are you fighting? Stonehouse. No, Greatwick. Greatwick and Lordsport against Sealskin Point and Stonehouse. Sure. So this is that guy. Oh, this is Sealskin Point. I believe. Who else is in there? Stonehouse. Is that Stonehouse? That's Stonehouse. House Stonehouse. Alright. Well, I'm not gonna raise any men, of course. Let them fight it out. Tywin has inherited Castamere from Geryon, who was executed by Tywin. Gee. What do you do? Come on, Eddard. Are you now, who's your liege? You still have no liege. Ah, there we go. Now he's back in the Iron Throne. Okay, so we have everyone under the Iron Throne again. That's nice. Except for Farwind. Farwind is still independent. That's a bug, actually. But, you know. Oh well. 5,000 men of Greatwick. Wow. I cannot raise that many. I can imprison this guy. Just end your plot, please. Thank you. And a new justice, sir. Harmond. He doesn't particularly like me, actually. He's ambitious. Well, I'm gonna pick you anyways, and maybe you can fabricate a claim on Orkmund. I need that claim. I'm just happy we got so much cash out of that reaving. Alright. 120 gold. Yeah, I guess we're just gonna... We could improve that in Harlow Hill. That's possible. Hmm. My spymaster died. Oh... He was slain by Excender Sunkso. Why is he down there? Are we still reaving? Well, oh, we're still reaving. Interesting. Okay. Well, let's get a new one. He was probably the best spymaster. And my courtier, she's craven, but she does have 14 points, so let's get her on the throne. And on the throne. Jesus. On the council here. Renly Baratheon. Right, Stannis is still in Storms as Dragonstone. Poor guy. I really wish he would have gotten the Stormlands. Not that I don't like Renly, it's just that Stannis is so badass. Okay, another fishing village. Yeah, now we've lost too many men. Yeah, we're only four people. We should probably go back. I don't know when this reaving will end. Probably gonna go on forever. Where do you get this cash from? Oh, it was our courier who died. And there it goes. The reaving has come to an end. We have returned from across the seas after abiding the old way of reaving and pillaging like a true Ironborn. We've gained much respect for our daring and ambition. Yep. I mean, it was certainly successful. I'm happy. Oh, and now Orkmund is now in this war as well. Lordswood and Orkmund. Hopefully he'll lose his army in the process, that will make it much easier for us to attack him later on. Go on, lose your army. Attack him. Greatwick. You have more men. Yeah, do it. Fight him. Even though it's 100%. Damn it. Ah, fine. Shit, I was hoping they would continue. Because now he has levy. He still has his levy, yeah. 2,600 men. That's a lot. I mean, I have more. But... still, I should probably improve something here. Castletown will give you more tax, stables, barracks, 45 men, petrol post, garrison size 5%. Yeah, I'm not sure. Ironborn shipyard, probably the Castletown to get the ducats, because we need cash. Making only one ducat, although militia draining. Yeah, that's more men. I'd rather have more men, really. No, actually, get the cash. Get the cash building. That's fine. It will help us. This is probably going to be a long run anyways, and we'll stay in Harlaw. I just like staying here. We've built so many castles until we could decide which one we want. That's why it's called Ten Towers, right? Because our lord built 10 towers and then he just merged them together. Because he couldn't decide where to live. Okay, so apparently everything is at peace here. No one's really revolting. You can almost say boring. Invite me to pay the iron price by joining me on the Reaving. Far to the north in the Shivering Sea, where we can target Lorathi and Ebony's ships. Oh, that's up here? He's asking me twice. I gained prestige. Let's see if I gain it twice. I actually did. That's awesome. Yeah, of course we join our friend Haras. I mean, of course. Hopefully we're gonna get something out of this. Or we die. Both would be good, really. Lord of Fountain has agreed to stand down. Raftons. Okay. So where's the Aaron holding? In my Robert Let's Play, I said it wrong. I said that the Craftons lost Ghoul Town, which they didn't. So yeah, thanks for pointing that out. But where is the Aaron stronghold? I thought there was one. Ghoul Tower? Was it Ghoul Tower? Or was it Ghoul Hall? I don't know. Ooh, what's this? The men were enjoying many a hard drink after a good day's reaving when Boromund Harlaw challenged Sigrun Harlaw, who was boasting of his reaving exploits, to a finger dance. Boromund was clearly the better of the two. He caught and dodged the axes most ably. Sigrun eventually submitted after losing a few fingers. Alright, so this guy, he should be disfigured, in my opinion. But oh well. Boromund. Cool. Good contest. Great. You guys are nuts. Yeah, my guy is still unlanded. During the attack, Haras was wounded. Well, he can't leave. He's leading this reaving. Haras Harlaw's attack on an enemy merchant fleet seemed foolhardy. The enemy merchants were too small-armed for us to take their gold. Too well-armed, I'm sorry. They utilized their warships to good effect, not allowing us to board their merchant vessels. We lost a few men. How am I losing prestige for that? It was his fault. What did we call Ironborn? As he captured a Salt Wife. Ooh. He did. A Lorathi Salt Wife. Good for him. He's 21. He's 50. The hell. Was sound. The fleet was fairly well defended. We lost a few men, but we did get... Oh, I'm gaining gold now. Interesting. Very, very nice. Maybe I don't want to change religion. This is just too good. One of my fellow reavers has come to be a great companion. Eric, my grandson. Okay. Wasn't that the one who fled last time? I don't know. We're good friends anyways. And now, oh no, I lose the trained fighter. I become a poor fighter. That's bad. Probably gonna get less loot now. Oh well. We're almost done building this. Yeah, it still takes a while. So what's going on here? Hospitality. Nobody's really doing anything. Mace. Everyone's still there. Everyone's still around. Nobody has died yet. The reaving party has been rowing the coast again. Okay, so a local patrol has spotted us and attacking. Being Ironborn, of course, we shall meet this challenge. Leader of their band stands before me with but one thought: to kill me. It's unfortunate we just lost our trained fighter because we're much weaker now. But we'll have to charge, of course, with the local master arms. Okay, in the midst of battle, you and Lothar circle each other, tense and focused. The raging scene around you seems slow down as you scan him for any sign of weakness, any opening in his defense that you could possibly exploit. Oh, he's also a poor fighter, but his dual skill is only 4. We have 4, his dual skill is 2. Alright, one mistake is all he gets. You see a weak spot, a vulnerability in Lothar's defense. It's not much, but it's all you need. Strike! Lothar tries to fight back, but you force your way through, easily overpowering his pathetic defense. You strike for his heart with all your might. Die! And there he goes. He was slain. Lothar crumbles to the ground, lifeless. You wipe his blood from your weapon. The deed is done. He's dead. Vala Morghulis. 25 prestige. Fight is over. I've won. Victory is mine. And that is nice. Thank you so much for watching. I will end the episode here. I'll see you next time. Steve Turunka, signing off.